provide reports to all the LibreOffice community. And I'm here for present the state of art in Italy. About me, well, my name is Marina Martini, and I work in the LibreOffice division of Studio Software. But I'm also a free software artist, and in Italy I'm a member of Free Software User Group Italia. I'm also an open source advocate, and now I'm also a LibreItalia founder. So I think that LibreOffice is an important way to promote open source in all the countries. We have a great community, and I'm very proud to be part of this family. What about Italian laws? Finally, we have an important law, a sort of milestone for our public administration. The Digital Administration Code is in effect since to 2006, and is a law that talks about digital rights, and finally talks about open source and open source software. So I want to present the relevant articles in this law. In particular, the article number 2 provides information about the purpose and the rights of the citizen. And in particular, we know that it's important the way how we communicate with the public administration. So the first thing is that we need to manage our governments. So we need to preserve the information. We need to transmit information, but first of all, we need to access our information. The information are of the citizen, so we need to liberate the information and the documents. Usability is another one key point. We need to access documents, we need to use our documents, and obviously we need to grant availability of the information. The article number 9 talks about the electronic participation of citizens, and the focus is the main aspect is that the citizens are at the center. We need to provide the possibility to participate to all the life event of the citizen, and the aspect related to public administration is one of these important aspects. So with article number 9 we can grant the electronic participation to the life of the public administration. The article number 50 is another one milestone in our law. The article talks about the data availability. It's important because the citizen need to
denied to access.
Okay. I thought so. So the citizen have the right to access to their documents and their information. We are talking about personal information. We are talking about documents like module, template, so all kind of documents can be accessed. And with Article 50, we grant this right. Security. In Italy, we have a strange concept of security. We talk about security, but we can't realize all the aspects related to security. Now, with this article, we specify how can we access our information. We specify how we need to realize our system and our infrastructure for create a sort of circular public administration. So security is going up, but this is a very important article for our public administration. And the Article 52 is the other aspect that we need to really implement in our public administration. We have a lot of failure. We have a huge amount of people. But now we need to grant electronic access of our data. And in particular, we need to work on reuse. So we can talk about a large amount of work about standardization and digitalization of our information. And the Article 68 is something important for the world of open source and force in general, because the law talks about the right to execute comparison and comparison analysis of the possible solution that we can rely on the market. And if there is an open solution, we need to choose the open one. So finally, the open source solution have the importance that they need. And about Article 68, we talk about reuse and use of free software. In particular, we know that there are a lot of programs that can do something for us, but we need to see if there is an implemented solution that can be used for us. So we need to see and reuse if there is something that fits need to prefer free software to closed or proprietary software. In Article 69, we talks about the reuse of the computer programs. So there is a database that can help the public administration to choose the right application. With this database, the public administration can search and can find a solution and can adopt the software that is in the database. We need to reuse, but we need to take care of portability. We can write our own software because of the database, there isn't something that fits for us. But this software needs to be portable, and we need to share this program with the other public administration. So portability, finally, is really important. When we use a program, we need to pay attention to the contract, the agreement. Why is it? Because in the law, we can read that on the contract, the public administration need to have the property of the software, the property of the documentation and the source code. So, for example, a third party software that realizes the program for us can't obtain the property of the software. The software is the property of the public administration. This is a sort of integration to the digital administration folder. The circular 63 talks about some guidelines to make a good comparative assessment. There are a lot of examples. The circular is not a list of right. This is a sort of example, a sort of guide where you can compare what is in the card, so in the law, and translate what a public administration needs to do for the
to be compliant with the law.
Compliant, okay. Thank you. This is a sort of user manual where the public administration can try some example and can know how can act and resolve the special problem that they are considering in this moment. Article 70, the database. This database is a database, a big database. There are a lot of programs. Some programs are made by third party software. Other programs are made by directly by the public administration. So this is example, this is a sort of best practice. A public administration realizes software, the public administration releases the software and insert the specification of the software in the database. So you can search and you can try a description of the software, and you can also ask the use and the reuse of the software. Okay, this is a sort of state of art in Italy, but in particular in my job experience. We know that public administration can use software, can reuse software, but there are also official channels where a public administration can buy software. This is a screenshot of this portal. There is an English version of the homepage, but the other content are in Italian. By the way, you can select what you are searching for. So you can select this if you are enterprise, or this if you are a public administration. Selecting one of these menu, you can search and find other software or tool that the public administration can provide and can use. And the problem for us is that here you can choose also Microsoft licenses. In particular, there are an agreement between Microsoft and the public administration. The public administration can acquire discounted licenses, and they can choose the single application, the entire suite. So there are a lot of software, not only software like Microsoft Office. Here you can acquire licenses for all the Microsoft products. So this is strange for us. But the problem are also the prices. The prices are online. You can read the price list without any login. And the price list is updated monthly. So those are the prices for updated to September, and this is only an extract of the price list. In particular, here we can read the prices of the standard version Office Pro Plus, or a sort of pack that includes the software and the software assurance. In any case, this price are for 1 seat. So are discounted prices, but the public administration can spend their money in another way. Okay. So what we can try to do with this public administration? we need to contact him, the public administration, or the director, or we need to have a contact in the public administration, and we need to fight the resistance to change. We need to take care of all the users in the public administration or in the that want to migrate from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice. In any case, we need to keep in contact with all the users, not only with the director. We need to provide feedback, because a user needs feedback. With constant feedback, the user is conscious of what we are doing for his public administration, for our public administration. And the support can reduce anxiety, can reduce fear. So the support is another aspect very important in our relationship. Another important aspect is related to communication. We need to talk with the user, and we need to ask to the user all the problem that the user is encountering during his daily work. So, in this way, we can reduce the resistance to change. This is our migration protocol that is based on TDF migration protocol. And during our work, we take care in particular of the analysis phase. This is important, and assessment needs to be as good as possible, because if you realize a wrong assessment, you need to do a lot of work to reach a good migration. And obviously, the impact test is the next step for a good migration. So this is the TDF migration protocol. In particular, now we are working with the municipality of Bari. This is a big work. The work is going on. It's going on a bit slowly, but we are in Italy, so we can wait. And this is the big problem, the first one. In Italy, we have a lot of different fashion. We haven't in a homogeneous system. Every public administration has tons of Microsoft Office version. So the first problem is to count the different version, take care of the number of licenses, because sometimes the number of licenses isn't exactly the number of Microsoft Office version installed. in our other personal computer. So this is the first things to do. And this difference from acquired and installed version can help us to start the migration process. In particular, those are other problems that are stopping our work. In particular with the municipality of Dubai, but in general in a lot of public administration, we have we don't know what are open funds, what is the concept of open data, or is not so clear what are the open formats. So the first problem is that we need to explain, we need to train the user, and sometimes a user guide can help our work. In particular, we have a big problem between open form, the definition of open format and open data. They confuse the terms, so they are sure that they are published all the documents with the correct format, because the format is corresponding to open data. This is the same thing. So we need to explain. And the other problem is that in our public administration, we have a lot of third party software. And all these software houses produce a sort of model template that the public administration can use for producing their documents. For example, they use a model for the in Italy we call this document the decreto. The documents that a public administration use every day. This document can be realized with a software that generates a sort of homemade RTF. See, yes, in Italy we have a problem with RTF format. All the software houses are convinced that RTF format is standard.
So also the public administration, CRTF is standard and open.
So RTF is a standard, RTF is open, so RTF is used everywhere. And this is a big problem for us. This document can be with an homemade RTF that produce problems where we can try to import or export with LibreOffice those documents, because we can't know what RTF version they are using. They produce RTF with Microsoft Office. We can't know what version of Microsoft Office they are using. So we can know what sort of RTF we are managing. So we need to collect all the problematic document and try to open with the LibreOffice and try to correct the problem in front. We had a few native RTF documents and the other test, the other documents are made with OpenOffice.org or Apache OpenOffice. But usually in our public administration, the users don't know that there is LibreOffice. They know that probably they know that there is Apache OpenOffice or OpenOffice.org. So this is also a problem of communication and working on it. Okay, how can we solve this problem? We have open and RTF bug on FreeDAXA. Now, those are the bugs that we have inserted in the bug. And with the other developer, in particular with Miklos, we are trying to solve this bug, not only for the Italian community, but also for all the international community. It's not so simple because usually we have documents that are very complex. The problems usually are related to anchoring of images or tables or lists. So we can group all the problems in these three big categories. And with Miklos, we are trying to solve this bug and to triage all the other documents that can be imported in a wrong way in the office. Okay, those are the credits of the new images. And for me, it's all. And there are questions.
We have a coffee break, eh?